From the historic Victorian port city of Manistee, Michigan, welcome to the 28th Annual Victorian Sleighbell Parade. Tonight, take a few steps back in time with one of Michigan's most unique holiday celebrations. Funding for tonight's telecast is provided by the Manistee Downtown Development Authority, Manistee DDA, working with our nearly 150 businesses and community resources in support of a growing and vibrant economic community. And now, here are your hosts for today's telecast, Dave Mix, and star of stage, screen, and television, Toni Trucks.
Welcome to the 28th Annual Sleighbell Parade from right here in downtown Manistee. I'm Dave Mix, and so happy to be with you, and joined again this year by none other than a star on stage, screen, and television, and Manistee's own, Toni Trucks.
Hello.
Toni, welcome home.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. So happy to be here.
We're so glad that you're once again this year. Lots of great things.
Me too. I think this is a good tradition we're developing.
I think so too. So this is the 28th year of the parade. And in all the years that you've lived in New York, you live in California now, all the travels and filming schedules and being off to college, how many of the 28 parades have you missed or been here for?
I confess I probably missed a few, but I think I participated in one of the first ones. I walked with Kennedy School all dressed in Victorian garb.
And we're going to see Kennedy in the parade.
That's right. Excited to see them. So, you know, everyone gets so excited to come to the parade and look forward to it so much because the Sleigh Bell Parade really is celebrating the tradition Manistee is founded on, the Victorian traditions. And as you look up and down the streets, you can really see that the buildings have been restored to or look exactly like they did 150 years ago. And that's why we get so excited to come home and to see this parade.
It's really a pretty... And a little later, we're going to take a little bit of a tour of some of the homes, of some of the buildings that are right here on River Street and see all of little pieces of the history.
Some of the good architecture.
Step back in time. That's exactly what we're going to do. But right now, we're going to check out some of the things that are actually taking place in the pre-parade activities. And I have to tell you, I've been watching this parade for 20-some years, and we have an incredible number of people here on River Street today.
It's already bustling. I think it's only going to get bigger and bigger.
I know, absolutely. One of the pre-parade activities that's taking place is right behind us here, the Merry Trombones.
Yes, the Merry Trombones are celebrating their 20th year in the Sleigh Bell Parade. And over the years, they've accepted all ages and ranges of talent in their group. And at some points, they've even had up to 50 members of professional and musicians.
Well, and the neat part about it is that a number of the people who are involved with the trombones are they frequently play with the Scottville Clown Band, which is always an incredible group to see. And if you've never had the opportunity of seeing the Scottville Clown Band, that's really a group you want to see sometime. Yeah. But in the meantime, we've got the group back here that's taking a break. They're moving to the next piece of music. And we're going to take just a little quick listen to the Merry Trombone. We're moving. Okay, so this is the time we usually catch up with what's going on with Toni Trucks.
Okay.
A few weeks ago, We saw you on the brand new CBS medical drama,
Pure Genius.
Pure Genius, And did you have fun on that?
I loved filming that. That's with Dermot Mulrooney, and who is actually an Interlochen student as well, Michigan guy. And he went to Interlochen camp for cello. So,
oh, neat.
Yeah, it was really neat. And but that was a really fun show to work on.
And I heard something about the fact that you were in New Orleans recently.
Yes, I was in New Orleans. I have a recurring role on a TV series called NCIS New Orleans, where I played their Coast Guard specialist, their CGIS agent.
So how'd you do out on the water?
I confess I get a little seasick. So if you look closely, you'll see a little scopolamine patch hiding behind my ear.
And what else do you have coming up?
Coming up also in the new year, I will have an episode of Criminal Minds Beyond Borders. So that's going to be a great show. That's with Gary Sinise.
Oh, indeed.
Yes.
Indeed. Well, all these good things that we'll be watching you for. And the CSI New Orleans is coming up. It's going to be on the air in...
NCIS New Orleans.
NCIS New Orleans is going to be on the air in January, I believe, correct?
Yep. Early January.
Super. Excellent. Well, you know, we were talking about all of the historical buildings, and there's someone who has done really an extraordinary amount of research, and we're lucky enough to have him here again with us, and he's standing right over here.
Hi, Mark. Glad
to be back for another year.
Happy to have you.
From the Manistee County Historical Museum.
That's correct.
Here in town. And you've done a lot of research about the buildings here on River Street.
Here, I've always had a, of course, love for Manistee, and now that I'm involved at the Manistee County Historical Museum, I spent a lot of time starting to research a lot of these buildings, and that kind of started early last year, and just this past summer, I did a history of not just a couple of these buildings, but each and every one of them in about a 2.5 hour, 3 hour tour, which was very long and very long-winded, too,
well,
on my part.
We joined part of it. It was a great tour.
It was a lot
of
fun.
But this building here, the Ramsdell Inn, is one of those buildings that when people come into Manistee, they look at this building and say, wow, this is just an absolutely
It's a very, very unique building. It's the key corner building that is here now in Manistee. And a lot of people always have a lot of questions about it, want to know its history. And we're going to talk a little bit about that in a couple minutes. But there's a lot more history to this building right across the street, which is kind of where the story begins. This building is called the Engelman Building. And it wasn't really built by Mr. Engelman, but the building that was here before it was built by Mr. Engelman. He eventually invested his money in a line of lake vessels, and from there he invested his money into timber and grew to become a man of very high stature. He became the mayor in about 1879, and through his connections, he started to get the idea of building a superstructure on the corner of River and Maple Street. And this building was kind of what we would call maybe a mini mall by today's standards.
Really?
There were barber shops, there were beauty shops, there was retail, there was also even a bank in there called the First National Bank. And that building was here until about 1909 when a bakery located right next door caught fire and spread across those bakeries,
those
Toni.
Yeah, exactly.
So it destroyed the entire building, and they had to rebuild it. And then by 1910, 1911, a new building was built here, and this was the building. It was called the Engelman Building because it was built by Mr. Engelman's son-in-law, who wanted to have his name remembered in the community.
Wow. Well, I'm just happy to hear that Manistee actually had one of the first mini malls in the late 1800s.
It really did. It really did. We always were. Always still are. Yeah.
Mark, is this building on your tour that you've given in the summer?
It is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. So is this building too, Toni? The Ramsdell Building, as we talked about a couple minutes ago. This building, like I said, is very unique in design. It was constructed by a man named Thomas Jefferson Ramsdell. And Mr. Ramsdell was very well known throughout the community. He was the city's first lawyer. He was also a businessman and a philanthropist. I wish we could be philanthropists, Toni. One day.
Yeah. One day.
But T.J. Ramsdell, like I said, was a lawyer, and he had another building here on River Street constructed for his law practice. And then he got the idea to construct this building, and there was a general store here built, but he purchased the property, had the general store knocked down, and then hired an architect by the name of F.W. Hollister, who is very well known in Manistee. He's also designed the firehouse as well as the old high school. And Mr. Hollister designed this very unique building with red granite and terracotta trimmings. And by 1891, it was ready to begin construction, and that it did. So by 1892, the building was complete, and the first occupants of the building were the Manistee County Savings Bank.
Okay. Now, that's where the beautiful boats are.
Exactly, you're exactly right. And the Manistee County Savings Bank, they thought it was kind of funny that he would allow that inside this building because he was actually the president of the First National Bank, which was located directly across the street. So that was kind of
a little friendly competition.
Friendly competition,
yeah,
exactly. Right.
Yeah. Also responsible for my favorite building. The Ramsdell,
Theater, yes. And that was built around 10 years after this building was constructed. 1902, 1903 is,
yep,
when,
oh,
is,
wow,
when,
okay,
1903 is when it opened.
Wow.
And very, very unique buildings, and he was a very well-known man, very loved man here. The interior inside this building, have you ever been inside the Ramsdell building
before?
I know you have, Toni.
Oh, I have. I love
and
it.
And the beautiful artwork and beautiful vaults from the bank and lots of neat stuff.
Yes. So, yeah.
Well, right. And Mark, that's sort of the start of our tour because we're going to take a tour of some of the buildings that kind of followed this,
yes,
down the road.
Yes, exactly. There'll be a few more neat stories here in just a little bit.
I'm standing here with our executive and economic development director, Tyler Lepinen. Tyler, every time that I come home to Manistee, I'm seeing all this exciting things happening. And this time, I'm seeing a lot of construction and development. Can you tell us what's on the table for the next year?
Yes, there's a lot of exciting development taking place in the city of Manistee. We have the Edgewater condos on the north side of the river, and then behind that, the North Channel Brewery. I'm told that we should expect occupancy relatively soon. And then we have the 11 homes on the Hotel Chippewa property being developed by the Chippewa Resort Properties. And they've been gracious enough to allow us to use their property for the fireworks display.
Great.
And then we have the Olsons project, which has a very good concept for senior living and to make that project viable for the long term. And then we have a developer for the former Glick's property right here.
So have you noticed that you've had to do any, reinforce any infrastructure in Manistee to keep up with the growth of the town?
Yeah, so the city's done a great job of building out and improving upon existing infrastructure in the district. They're expecting to reconstruct Memorial Drive in the future, resurface River Street, and many of the other streets in the district. So together, there's been a lot of private and public investment, which is very, very exciting for Manistee.
Now, with all the hustle and bustle in town, I heard through the grapevine that you might have some exciting news to share with us about Manistee in a town of our size. Can you share it with us?
Yes, the city of Manistee has been designated a redevelopment-ready community by the Michigan Economic Development Corporation. Manistee is the 9th community in the state to receive that designation. And what that means is that the city has sat down and taken a look at all their processes as far as zoning and permitting and really compared that to the best practices in the industry and made improvements where possible. In addition to going through that process, the MEDC will help the city market redevelopment-ready sites to a larger audience. It should really signal to people that Manistee is open and ready for business.
That's wonderful. Now, this broadcast, you know, we're reaching people across the state, and now with the internet, we're reaching people across the globe. So if anyone's watching this telecast and they want to visit Manistee, where can they go or where can they call to find out more?
Yes, if somebody is looking for more information for downtown Manistee, they're more than welcome to contact me. My number at the office is 231-398-3262, and my email is tyler.lepinen, L-E-P-P-A-N-E-N, at manisteedowntown.com, or they could visit our website at visitmanistee.com.
All right, well, you heard it here.
Tell me what is one of the most favorite parts of the parade every year that gets you excited?
Well, obviously the tree is,
well,
huge.
Of course.
It's a huge thing.
But isn't,
I do love the Keystone Cops.
Really? And why would that be?
I'm not really sure why I would love the Keystone Cops.
So this just happens to be one of the Keystone Cops,
yes,
who's
here,
part of the parade.
Here.
Except that I have to share with the audience that this is a very special Keystone Cop because why?
This is my father, America.
And this is Lee Trucks.
Hi, Dad.
This is Lee Trucks. So, Lee, how long have you been not only a Kiwanian, but how long have you been part of the Keystone Cops?
I don't know. I'm thinking maybe 18 years or something like that, maybe 20.
How long have the Keystone Cops been a part of the parade, Dad?
Ever since I can remember. I think maybe the Keystone Cops were here before there was a Forest Festival parade.
Before there was a parade?
Yeah. Yeah, really? They were for some other events.
No.
How do you see the? Dave. How do you see the role of the Keystone Cops for the parade? What do you think they do?
We keep the rowdies out. We've been trying to limit the crowd, but we've been real unsuccessful at that. I had to issue a citation to this guy. It was about 10 feet tall for excessive height.
Okay.
We've had some people in some of the bars here that were overage drinking. You know, I mean,
it's a real problem, Manistee. Real problem.
So, I mean, we do our best, you know, but protect and serve, you know.
So if I had to sum it up, I'd say general merriment and joy given by the Keystone Cops while also keeping everyone in order.
Yes, absolutely. It's that order that's so important.
And that's really sort of what it's all about, isn't it?
Yeah.
And having a good time.
Yeah.
So you're going to go back and you're going to get into line so that we can see you coming down the pike here shortly.
Yeah, we'll beat all the people on the sides into submission so that, you know, the parade has.
Dad, do you have a billy club or something that you're? Okay, so if something goes amiss, we know what happened.
So don't mess with us.
All right. You won't mess
Lee,
with
have a great time.
Right.
Thank you.
Thanks,
and,
Dad.
And I just want you to know, you have an absolutely incredible daughter.
Thanks, Dan. Thanks, Dave. Thank you, everyone.
We have all sorts of great things going on here on River Street. And I believe I'm catching up with my script here, as a matter of fact.
I'm just wondering, are there some chestnuts around here that we can see? Or what's happening?
Chestnuts, a lot of good things.
There's a warming tent.
But there are also a lot of other exciting things that are taking place here in town. And we had an opportunity a little while ago of chatting with Rachel Brooks, who's she is the chairman of all of the Sleigh Bell Weekend activities.
Right.
And so we caught up with Rachel, who is very busy this weekend.
Well, it's three days of events.
I know, 3 days of activities. So let's take a look at the conversation that we had with Rachel Brooks. Rachel, thank you for taking some time to join us down here. This is such an exciting weekend. Tell us a little about the parade. There's some traditions that are returning to the parade this year, right?
There are. We always have our 30-foot Christmas tree that's pulled by a team of draft horses. And this year we brought another tree that is almost just as big back into the parade, again pulled by a team of beautiful, gorgeous draft horses.
Well, and we were saying earlier, the two trees, when I saw them, usually it was a children's tree a number of years ago, which was substantially smaller. This year, as you said, the trees are both enormous trees.
They're just right around the same size, so it should be absolutely spectacular coming down River Street.
And there are some new entries in the parade this year?
We do. We have some new entries, and I think it's just going to be absolutely beautiful with these new entries.
And you've got some other new things that have been added this year. I think it's Douglas Valley Winery that's involved.
Douglas Valley has a warming tent, and visitors and residents can warm up, have a glass of wine, coffee, hot chocolate. And they also have some fire pits, so you can stand around those and watch the parade.
I think I should go down there. I think Toni and I are going to head down to the fire pit as soon as the parade is over. And Douglas Valley also has some something special. Tell us about this.
Douglas Valley is featuring a Sleigh Bell white and red wine. You can get it at Douglas Valley downtown, and it's $19.95 a bottle.
And they've been very popular, you tell me.
They're flying off their shelves.
Are these a limited time wine?
We have them this year, and we hope to bring them back again next year.
Oh, that's great. Well, thank you for all the work that you and the committee are doing. I know that this is an absolutely extraordinary weekend, and we're going to have thousands of people here in town for the parade and for all the other activities.
It's going to be spectacular, and if you haven't been to Manistee, this is the weekend to come. It is just wonderful and lovely, and it's events for the entire family.
Thank you, Rachel.
Thank you.
So glad that you could spend some time away from all of the other activities that are going on. Have a great rest of the weekend.
You too, Dave. Thank you.
You know, we talk about the Victorian buildings here on River Street and throughout Manistee. It's not only that, it's the fact that on Sleigh Bell Weekend, when you go into any of the stores in Manistee, you're going to be waited on by clerks who are dressed that they look like they just stepped out of the 1890s. And with us today, we have Janet Duchant and her stepson, Stephen, who are part of what is referred to here as ambassadors.
That's right.
During the Sleighbell Parade.
And ambassadors can really answer all of your questions, where you need to go. There are walking, gorgeous information booths. So I want to know from you guys what this sort of tradition means to you.
Yeah, you know what I think it is, Toni? I think you can agree with me. I was born and raised in Manistee. And to be able to come back every single year and to walk down the streets and welcome people here, you got to remember, a lot of people are coming here for the first time. So you want to create that tradition so they keep coming back. And I think if you've achieved that, that's what we're hoping we can do.
Seems like we're doing it. I think like we're doing it. What about you, Jen?
This is always extremely exciting for me because I participated in the very first Sleighbell Festival 28 years ago. I'm a part of the Sleighbell Committee along with Dave. I actually am the manager at Chemical Bank. We are the signature sponsor of Sleighbell. So this is very exciting. I head up the ambassadors and Santa's headquarters. So we look forward to this weekend every year.
So Janet, what other events do the ambassadors make appearances at and participate in throughout the year?
We don't do a whole lot throughout the year. Primarily, we do the Sleighbell Festival. We do Santa's headquarters. We assist wherever we're needed. We assisted today with the carriage rides. We walk up and down and answer questions.
How many ambassadors do you have walking? Because I ran into a whole slew earlier that were beautifully dressed, just like yourself, answering questions, handing out candy canes.
There's generally about a dozen, but there's one special little ambassador, my granddaughter, who's 5 years old.
I think she's going to have all the answers, probably.
She loves it. We look forward to it every year.
And the other interesting thing is, I don't know that it's part of the ambassador's program, but frequently there are cruise ships that come into Manistee, come up the Manistee River, and they're greeted by people who are in Victorian dress as they come in and as the guests come off the ship. So it's pretty neat. Janet, Stephen, thank you so
thank
much
you
for
so
being
much.
With us today.
Thank you for sharing
and
us.
Have just a wonderful time this
thank
weekend.
You.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. We'll see you in the parade.
You know, the wonderful thing about this is that anybody who comes to Manistee, all they have to do is ask the ambassadors where the nearest Chestnut station is.
Where the
you
nearest
know?
Hot chocolate or sleigh bell wine is. They know it. They know it all.
That's it. And when you start talking about chestnuts, just in case anybody is wondering, yes, they really are roasting over an open fire. And all you need to do is walk up with a gloved hand, reach out, and they hand you a chestnut.
To you. There's several stations up and down the drag here.
It's a great thing. A great thing to do here in town, that's for sure. So next year when you come, you need to do that.
Come with an appetite.
I know. I think we're going to go back and talk with Mark Federer, I believe. We've got a little continuation of Mark's tour.
Our tour earlier. Yeah.
And he's going to kind of pick up the story where we left off as we were looking at the beautiful Ramsdale Inn
That's
behind
right.
us. Let's take a look at the rest of the story. We were talking about the Manistee County Savings Bank that was in the Ramsdale Inn. So tell us about how it wound up moving to the building behind us.
Well, the Manistee County Savings Bank opened in the Ramsdale building in 1892. By the early 1900s, they had outgrown their quarters in the Ramsdale building, so they were looking to expand. So a clothing salesman here in Manistee by the name of Jacob Ahrens, very well known, very popular guy, he had a couple of buildings here on the corner of Poplar and River Street, and so he decided to sell the Manistee County Savings Bank his property for about $26,000.
Mark, can you tell us a little bit about the embellishments on the building?
Well, this particular building was built in 1906 and into 1907, and it's kind of a colonial-style revival building. You can see by all the different columns that they have on front of the building. There's two emblems which kind of spell out all together. Manistee County Savings Bank is on the front of the building, and then there's emblems with the initials MCSB with two emblems right on the front entrance. So it's very unique and very of its time.
Mark, do they have the huge vaults in this bank as they do in some of the other buildings downtown?
They do as well. It's a very large vault. Basically, after they had finished the first floor of the building, they had to weigh it to make sure that everything, nobody would seep through the first floor of the building. building and go down the basement. So they put 14 tons of weight as well as 23 men to make sure that the first floor was stable enough for them to continue on with their with the rest
a
of the work.
Human sacrifice.
Human sacrifice, exactly, okay. Toni. Yeah, right. Good way to put it.
Thank
yeah.
You.
And apparently it was successful because the bank is still standing.
The bank is still standing. Over 100 years later, it's still standing. And not to my knowledge, no one has fallen through the first floor yet. But you never know.
Okay. Time will tell.
Time will tell.
So far, so good.
Yeah.
So the bank was here, and then the store that used to be here moved, correct?
Yeah. Yes, as I mentioned earlier about Jacob Aarons, the clothing salesman, he moved just a little ways down the street to the corner of Greenbush and River Street in two small buildings where he continued his business for the next several years.
Let's take a look at that building then. Mark, tell us a little about the Aarons building.
Well, as I mentioned earlier, talking about the Manistee County Savings Bank building, Jacob Aarons, who was the person who had that property, sold it to the bank. And after he sold it to the bank, he moved into two smaller stores that were on the corner here of Greenbush and River Street. That was about 1906, 1907. And it was always his dream to build a very big structure on this particular corner after he had moved here. Unfortunately, he passed away, but his son and daughter kept the dream alive and built this magnificent three-story structure here right on the corner of Greenbush and River Street.
And I'm noticing that the name Aarons is still on the building, as are some of the other structures.
Yes, and I always think a very cool tribute to the people who came before us and the people who were a big part of this town. This building here became one of the premier buildings in downtown Manistee and was a very popular place for people to buy clothing. And the Aarons family was very well known. There are no descendants of the family but that are still living here in Manistee, but when you see the name on front of the building, I think that's a very big honor.
A good homage.
Absolutely, Toni.
Now, Mark, am I getting woozy here, or is this an optical illusion? Because the building doesn't look exactly straight. What's happening?
You're not getting woozy, Toni. it's a little bit of an optical illusion, but when you look at the building straight on, when you're on River Street, looks like it's a square building. But then when you kind of go a little further up the street, you notice that it kind of follows the same pattern of Greenbush Street. It kind of goes up. So it's not entirely square, I should say. So it's a very unique building.
But a beautiful building, really.
Beautiful building as well. The same brick that was used to construct this building was used to construct the Ingman building, which we talked about a little bit earlier in the day. The same contractor who constructed this building also constructed that building. It's not the most outstanding fact in the world, but just a cute little tidbit that's kind of unique to Manistee. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Sure. So we sort of have with the square building, it's sort of like Manistee's Flatiron building of New York.
Possibly. Yes. I won't quite go that far, but I would say yes. What the heck? We'll go that far. Yeah, absolutely, Dave.
Mark, thank you. This has really been fascinating to look at some of the buildings. Thanks so much. We're glad you're here. We're up in our podium up here.
Our usual
up in
perch.
The sky, yeah. And I am told that the parade has started, and if we look down the street, we should be able to see some of the activities, and your dad and the Kiwanis Keystone Cops should be coming down the street, and there they come.
There they come. Yes, it looks like the parade has begun. The Keystone Cops are on their way, leading tonight's procession, just like they've done for nearly the entire history of the Sleigh Bell Parade.
And as we said before, I think that these guys really just enjoy greeting the crowds instead of anything that resembles crowd control.
Your dad has
such a good time with this. I mean,
he truly does. You know, the Keystone Cops are tricky because they don't necessarily travel in a line. They like to mingle and harass.
And look at that. There's somebody all lit up.
All
couple
lit
of kids
up.
All lit up.
Wonder
on
where
pads.
He keeps his battery pack.
How about that? And here comes the start of the parade. These are the folks coming right behind the Keystone Cops, Kiwanis Cops.
Look at them. They look so great.
I know, don't they, though?
They've got quite a team. You know, there's my dad on the right side of your screen. He was fearful they were going to run out of uniforms. He said there was so much interest in being a Keystone Cop this year.
How about that?
Yes, the Kiwanis are very popular.
And right behind them are the folks from Chemical Bank,
yes.
The Sleigh Bell Parade sponsor again this year.
That's right. Chemical Bank has been the parade sponsor for many years and the parade organizers. So they're right there behind the Keystone Cops. The entire city really appreciates the dedication to this event from Chemical Bank. They've done it forever.
Oh, absolutely. And coming right behind Chemical Bank, and we can already begin to hear them. This is the group from Muskegon. It's the Muskegon Regional Police Pipes and Drums. The group
That's
was
right.
formed in 2004 in Muskegon and performs throughout West Michigan and beyond. But wherever they perform, they always celebrate the spirit of Highland music, especially during the holidays.
That's right. The band is wearing the ancient Hume tartan with the permission of the Hume clan. And they do that in honor of Thomas Hume, who's one of the civic leaders of early Muskegon.
And they also wear dark blue police-style shirts with a shoulder patch that was specifically designed for the band, the Muskegon Regional Police Pipe and Drums.
They sound great. Well, right behind them, here comes none other than Queen Victoria herself. Well, actually, it looks more like Joanne Cleaver, I think, who's looking probably more elegant than Queen Victoria did, I think, tonight.
I would say so. And this is the, I think the...
Oh, it's the Nay Haven here, another great wagon team. This is Nay Haven Stables in nearby Ludington. They offer a wide variety of programs for riders, and all they say is they want to better promote a better relationship and safety with your horse.
Well, one thing is obvious. They're all having a great time. They love to ride, and they all look like outstanding horsemen.
Yes, they do. Wonderful riders on the wagon there as well. And here comes the carriage from the Student Senate from West Shore Community College, established in 1967. West Shore is located near Ludington and offers associate and applied arts and sciences degrees, 1- and 2-year certificates, and much, much more.
And we're so glad that the students from West Shore are joining us again this year here in the parade.
Now behind them, you're going to see our super scoopers again, helping out, keeping things in order with the horses. They're members of the Onekama High School equestrian team.
And I'll tell you what, everybody on the parade is glad they're here. They're certainly familiar with the routine. Everybody on the parade appreciates their pitching in.
And here comes the Manistee Spirit of the Woods Garden Club. Their tree costumes represent the spirit that they spread through Manistee County as they replace the trees that are lost to disease and brush fires. And their volunteers also spend time attending memorial and community gardens throughout the area.
Well, and right behind them is the patriotic living flag that we will see in just a moment.
I think they may have been in front of them.
Yeah.
Yep. That was a beautiful flag, though. That was a living flag.
There we go, the living flag. They participated for many years as the Benzie Manistee Snowbirds, but about a year ago, they donated their uniforms to the Spirit of the Woods Garden Club so the tradition could continue right here in the Sleigh Bell Parade.
And here comes, I can sort of see in the distance coming up, RR. Yes, elves on stilts. The stilt walkers are really popular in parades now and at festivals during the Victorian era and the early 20th century. And they're no exception here this weekend.
Well, Neil has done an incredible job in his stilt walking and also fundraising. And here comes the Shoreline Cycle Club. The Lumberjacks seem to have taken quite a historical leap from the late 19th century. The club members are all from Manistee and Mason County areas.
Yes, and they're riding fat bikes. Those are bikes that have 4 to 5 inches tires, so they can literally ride throughout the year. They can ride in sand in summer and snow in the winter.
Really versatile.
And here are the children and adults from Trinity Lutheran School, and they're all dressed up as shepherds and wise men, angels from the nativity scene.
Don't they all look cute, though?
They sure do. Look at the little line of angels there. Oh, they even got their dog dressed up.
Here's another new unit this year. These are this is Sharnash and her four-year-old Irish spotted Newfie Breslin. And Char says, yes, he really is named after the Breslin Center at Michigan State University.
Okay. Now, plus, Breslin is a therapy dog through the Alliance of Therapy Dogs. And he and Char have lived in Grand Haven, Michigan, and this is Char's third Newfie. And as you know, Newfies were originally bred during the 1800s as working dogs for firemen.
And right behind is the all-volunteer Eastlake Volunteer Fire and Rescue Squad.
Yes, they're pulling what was their very first piece of fire equipment that they bought during the turn of the century. This was their soda ash cart.
And here comes the Manistee High School Marching Band under the direction this year of Andrea Matt, who joined the faculty this year after several award-winning years at Allegan High School.
The band is over 50 members and had a great record of competition recognition throughout the years. Should we listen?
They're moving right along.
Club in Manistee, the Lakeside Ladies Club. Last year, the club celebrated its 130th anniversary with its summer home tour in July during the Manistee's annual Forest Festival. That's the time the main fundraising events happen, and they do every other summer. They do every other summer to raise funds for a variety of activities that they support here in town.
And I'll tell you, the financial support for all of the causes that they've been involved with have been really important right from the start.
Here goes the ambassadors. We met a couple of these folks earlier. There are Victorian Weekend ambassadors, and they are literally walking information booths for all of the visitors here in Manistee during the weekend. Next year, when you join us here in person, give one of them a try and just ask where the nearest chestnut roasting station is. They'll know.
They do a wonderful job, that's for sure. And here's your old school.
Yes, here they are. This group has participated in every one of the 28 sleighbell parades. Its students are from Manistee's Kennedy Elementary School. All the kids are dressed in Victorian style attire, and they're in the school's fourth through sixth grades. This was my first walk in the parade was with this school.
And some of them even look like they're dressed as chimney sweeps there. Well, here is an interesting...
Yes, the Victorian fireman and his wife. They've come out for a walk with their faithful Dalmatian Blaze. This is Fred and Sue LaPointe. Fred is actually an engineer and paramedic with the City of Manistee Fire Department. He's been there for over 35 years, and this is his 27th time that they've appeared in the Sleigh Bell Parade.
And Blaze is a six-year-old Dalmatian, and this is the third dog that they've had in the parade. But right behind them...
Yes, under the direction of Robert Grass, here comes the Manistee Catholic Central High School Marching Band, and they're joined by a number of other Catholic Central students. Ah, they're in there.
Great. Well, it looks like we have a lot of girls who are headed off to bed in their Victorian pajamas.
Yes,
here.
These are the Girl Scouts from here in Manistee County. We have girls representing Manistee Senior Troop 10148, Manistee Troop 3764, and that's made up of Brownies, Juniors, and Cadets, and the Onakama Brownie Troop 4644. The Girl Scouts have been helping young ladies develop their leadership abilities, decision-making, and skills, and gain self-confidence since 1912. I know they helped me out.
Fantastic. And here's another new addition to the parade this year. It's the Little Manistee Watershed Council. For 20 years, the council's goals have been to restore, protect, and preserve the natural character of the watershed, and they're doing a great job. And here is the Tittabawassee Valley Fife and Drum Corps. The members are all wearing uniforms that could have been worn by the Continental Marines between roughly 1778 and 1781.
And the descendants of the unit eventually evolved into what's today's United States Marine Corps. And the flag bearers are carrying some of the most famous flags of the American Revolution.
Well, here we have the Manistee Youth Chorus. The group is celebrating its third anniversary. It is made up of 23 youngsters between the ages of 7 and 17.
The chorus is under the direction of Joy Smith, and they just recently had their annual concert that featured the music of Mary Poppins, as well as some other traditional numbers.
And as a unique artisan mall here in Manistee, Redeemed Furniture, Decor, and More joins the Sleighbell Parade for the first time this year with a vintage sleigh.
Yes, this isn't a horse-drawn sleigh. This is one that is pushed through the snow and was known as a snow cutter. The cutter served as a...
And I don't see the sleigh.
Oh, where's the sleigh today?
I don't know.
Well, maybe there was no snow to cut it.
This is the... Calvin Norman Dixon and Bear Lake Bands that have joined together.
Yes, under the direction of Brenna Richardson, here comes the combined Calvin Norman Dixon Band and Bear Lake Bands. And here's another new addition to the parade this year. This is the appearance by the Michigan Wheelmen. And what a perfect addition to our Victorian parade.
This statewide group is just a small part of over 1,000 members of the nationwide Wheelmen nonprofit organization who are dedicated to keeping the heritage of American cycling alive.
And here's another group that's been in every single sleighbell parade since the beginning, Coldwell Banker, ALM, Realty and Associates. And just what does ALM stand for? Well, along Lake Michigan, of course. And here's always the beautiful entry once again this time of year. This is Katniss Paris riding Century Oak Windstar, otherwise known as Henry. A couple of years ago, Katniss earned the nickname the Russian Princess because of her elegant attire. So it stuck.
And Katniss and Henry have been riding together for over 9 years. Henry is a Morgan and also is an extremely successful show jumper, which is something pretty rare for Morgan horses.
And here's another group that's been in the parade for a number of years. It's Stevens Farm. Last year they brought a covered wagon, and the year before that they brought a covered wagon that dated back to 1836. Now that's a really old wagon.
Yeah, you have to wonder if they really used this on the ranch, or did they just put it up on blocks?
Is it just preserved?
I'm not sure, yeah.
Not sure.
Yeah. Great bike.
Well,
beautiful wagon. Look at all the people.
So many people.
A lot of people here in town tonight. And this is West Shore Bank, it looks like, coming up.
Yes, our next entry is West Shore Bank, and it truly qualifies to be in the Victorian parade. The bank was founded back in 1898 and has continued to serve the West Shore area ever since. This year, along with their regular participants, they've added a mini pony to their team.
that West Shore continues to be involved with the community, helping out during the holiday season. This is the eighth year that they've teamed up with local grocery stores with their Spirit of Giving program. Bank has been collecting donations from customers in the community, as well as providing matching funding to provide complete meals to families suffering financial problems.
And here's another entry this year into the parade is the fabulous Stagecoach from the Double J Resort in Rothbury. The coach is being pulled by the beautiful team of black Percherons, Thelma and Louise, and the coach are just from the families who lived on the sprawling 1,000-acre ranch there.
Oh, wow. And the outline rider is Jennifer Pomeroy, who is the equine program director at the Double J Resort. And the stagecoach is a replica of a Concord stagecoach painted in the traditional red and gold colors of the Wells Fargo Company. That's quite the stagecoach, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's really beautiful.
Beautiful.
They look like they're cozy on the inside there, I think.
Absolutely.
Is that Santa on the inside there?
I don't know. It could have been. It could have been.
And here they are, the bell ringers from Century 21 Boardwalk here in Manistee. They've been a staple for many years in the parade, clanging their way down River Street.
A couple of years ago, I asked one of the members of the group if there was anything special we could say about them.
Yes.
And she sort of laughed, and she said, "Well, just tell people that we're a bunch of ding-a-lings."
We have permission to call them that?
I don't know. She said we could, so, you know.
We'll see.
Sure.
Well, hopefully we'll be able to hear them as they come by.
I know.
I caught a tiny performance earlier as I was walking down, and it was beautiful. They do a great job.
And, of course, everybody is always gathered to watch what is really unique to this parade, which is the Christmas trees coming down the street upright, already decorated. And they'll be coming along here shortly.
And some of the chestnuts roasting.
Not only that, but the kids are also waiting to see that fellow who rides along with the trees.
Who is that guy?
I don't know. We'll have to see once.
What is his name?
Santa, I'm not sure.
Well, our Century 21 is coming into view here, and we can just hear them. I wonder if they rehearse during business hours or after.
And look who we have coming here. We have...
Yes, here comes the guy everyone has been waiting for. This is Santa Claus. And there's no sled for Santa this year. He's going to ride in style in a carriage from Common Gentry Carriage.
And I don't know how lucky a kid can actually get to ride into town with Santa, but enjoying his time with the jolly old elf, I believe if we look real carefully, we're going to see none other than Wyatt Baker. Wyatt is a five-year-old from all the way from Grand Rapids who is hitching a ride with Santa tonight.
I wonder if he's had an opportunity to tell Santa what he wants under the tree this year on this long ride.
Boy, I don't know, but he certainly seems to be having a good time.
I think so. He looks nice and bundled up. Oh, Santa's looking grand.
And Santa looks like he stepped right out of the 19th century, too. And here we have...
the Cadillac Mounted Police, yes. As the two huge trees begin their journey down the river street, they're led this year by the Mounted Police Team from Cadillac Police Department's Auxiliary Mounted Patrol Unit. Here's Jim Ray and Gwen Johnson leading the trees this year, and their horses are specially trained for crowd control and events just like this.
And Gwen and Jim do a number of events like Sleighbell for Cadillac Police Department and are frequently seen at festivals, concerts, and major community events in Cadillac. They also conduct safety programs in area schools throughout the year.
Oh, Dave, here comes what everyone has just been waiting for. The Christmas trees are being pulled this year by a team of horses down River Street. And after a sort of gap for a few years, once again this year, we're going to have two trees.
How cool.
Here they come.
First tree is about, it's actually about 35 foot high. It's being pulled by a team of Percherons.
Oh, the first tree is?
Yes, I believe so. I'm looking to see. Oh, you know what? I think this is the second tree.
This must be.
Yes.
I think the second tree's coming first.
I think so.
Yes. That one is a very strong. And again, this year, this tree, if this is our second tree, and I believe it is, it's being pulled by a dynamic team of Belgian horses that are all being expertly controlled by Ben Reed. And Dave, these horses really do have a big job. Jeff McCula, Manistee's head of Public Works Department, guesstimates that the over 35-foot tall tree weighs somewhere around 4 tons.
What an incredible tree. Just beautiful.
Wow. Wow, look at that.
Just incredible, just incredible.
Wowie zowie. Amazing, and the procession begins.
Well, we still have more coming from the 28th Annual Sleighbell Parade here in Manistee. The singing of carols, the countdown, the lighting of the huge Christmas trees, and obviously to top off all the festivities, another spectacular fireworks show.
That's right.
But first, while there's always a good time to be had throughout Manistee in the winter, keep in mind that we're right here on the shore in Lake Michigan, and we're just a minute or so away from 26 miles of some of the most fantastic beaches in the state. And there's no better way to enjoy those beaches in the summertime than to plan to spend part of your summer here in Manistee at the annual Forest Festival during the week of July 4th. Let's take a look.
Manistee, Michigan welcomes you every summer. With the Manistee National Forest Festival. There's something for all ages during the 5 full days at the Manistee National Forest Festival. There's nothing quite like being near water in the summer. And Manistee has miles of Sandy Lake, Michigan beaches. Come see what we have to offer at the Manistee National Forest Festival. The Manistee National Forest Festival.
Well, we just want to thank everyone for coming out tonight. We had such a beautiful, beautiful Victorian Sleigh Bell Festival Parade and Old Christmas Weekend. And we honestly, we couldn't do it without the help of so many people in the community. So on your screen right now, you're going to be seeing the list of just some of the names of the people that have made tonight's telecast possible.
And we thank them all. And, you know, it now is the time for you to start thinking about joining us next year for Sleigh Bell Parade 29. 29 years? Oh, you're going to be back next year, aren't you?
I'm definitely coming back. Are you going to be back too?
I think we'll come back, yeah. So plan to come back, bring your friends, bring your family, and have a great time, and step back in time right here in Manistee. And until next year, when you do join us here in Manistee, I'm Dave Mix.
And I'm Toni Trucks.
And we're just wishing you a very happy, happy Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
Good night.
Good night.
Funding for tonight's telecast has been provided by the Manistee Downtown Development Authority, Manistee DDA, working with our nearly 150 businesses and community resources in support of a growing and vibrant Manistee downtown. This program has been a production of the Grand Rapids Community Media Center. And for now, on behalf of the Victorian Sleigh Bell Volunteer Committee, this is Kevin Richards, wishing you and yours a very happy holiday season and a prosperous new year.